Do you want to set up parental controls for your child's iPad or iPhone? We used to have to purchase apps to find out what our kids were doing on their screens, but now with this new feature by Apple called Screentime, we're able to find out exactly what they're doing on their devices. I'm Stephanie Anderson, and I show entrepreneurs how to work from home with their kids and how to keep their kids busy. Subscribe to my channel and click the bell so you know when I create new videos each week. If you worry about the time spent or the content that's being viewed on your child's devices, don't worry, because by the end of this video, you'll have an easy way to monitor screen time on Apple iPhones and Apple iPads. You can keep track of what apps kids are using, set time limits, control their in-app purchases, choose which apps they use, and limit websites. So step one, grab your phone. Do you have family sharing set up? Let's grab your phone and set up family sharing so you can turn on the feature called Ask to Buy, so you know exactly what they're buying on their phones or iPads. Set up family sharing. You want to make sure you go into your settings button and you want to click on your Apple ID. So when you click on your Apple ID, if you scroll down and you go to family sharing, you can click on that and you should be able to, if you are the organizer of your family, you should be able to add family members. You can see here that my husband, myself, and our three children are already added as family members. And if you go into each one of them, there's a button that says ask to buy, and you want to make sure that this says on. All right, so you go to each of your children, make sure that ask to buy is on. Step two is the screen time controls. So go into settings and you want to scroll down till you see screen time. So here you can see that I've spent this much time on my own screen, but below that you'll see there are four options, and these are going to be options for each person that you're setting up screen time for. So the first one is downtime, then app limits, always allowed, and content and privacy restrictions. So let's go into my son's, and we can see that for downtime, I've set up that he cannot access his screens for after 9 p.m. and before 7 a.m. But you can see here, you can customize the days, the times, and you can block the screens at the downtime of your choice. So after downtime, you can go to app limits. This is if you want to set specific time limits for specific apps. So I don't have anything set up specifically for apps, but I have all the apps and categories for no more than 2 hours a day. Now the reason we have it so high is because the kids use their devices in school. And so right now, I'm not really sure, but we never even get anywhere close to 2 hours, 1 minute. But you can see if you can go in, that you can edit apps in different categories and block them. Then if you go back to always allowed, this is kind of where you want to make sure they have emergency contact information and apps and functions in the phone that if there's an emergency, they can always access. So for us, we have little kids, so we don't have to worry about texting. So we have texting for emergencies and FaceTime, since they don't actually make phone calls from their iPads. And then lastly, under content and privacy restrictions, this is a pretty key one. So you can go into iTunes and App Store purchases. And for here, we have allow because, as you remember from the family sharing, we have it asking us if they want to buy anything. So we leave these as allow. And then allowed apps, same thing, because it's asking to buy. Under content restrictions, this is pretty important. So we have under ratings for, and you want to set your country. We have United States. And then under music, podcast, and news, we have it in the clean as opposed to explicit. Music profiles and posts, we have these off so they can't create their own profiles without us knowing about it. And movies, we have a rating of PG-13, but you can see you can go to all the different ratings if you like. And then TV shows, we have TV-14. I guess we probably should have put TV-PG. And then books, clean books. The options are clean or explicit. And under apps, we have 9+. But you can see there's a lot of like specific capabilities inside here. And then under web content, we have limit adult websites. So if you wanted to get really specific about what you will and won't allow, this is a place that you can add that. So web content is a pretty key area. And then with Siri, which is voice commands, we have it not allowing explicit language and allowing web search since they do a lot of research at school. And then finally, under Game Center, we're still allowing our kids to screen record and do multiplayer games, but not allowing to add friends because we figure if that's something that they want to do, that they should be asking us about that. Is this making sense to you? If it's easy, let me know with a comment below. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask and I will get back to you as soon as I can. Step 3 is website data. Let's figure out how to set up our website data and make sure we have the toggle in the right place. Okay, lastly, for website data, the way you go set that up is go into settings again and then scroll down to screen time. And here, when you have your children set up, if you click on their name, underneath downtime, app limits, always allowed, and content and privacy restriction is the words include website data. So if you have this off, it will not show you what your kids are looking at. But if you have it on, you can then go in and view the different websites that they have viewed. And the way you do that is you go up to the top and you at the top where it says Will's iPad, you click on that and it's going to show you right down here all of the places that he was online. So it's pretty cool. You can really get in and see what they're doing or not doing on their device. And you can go from today at the top over till the last 7 days too. And it even categorizes out for you for education, productivity, and creativity. But it's pretty key for us to be able to see what kinds of things they're doing on their iPad so we can make sure that they are being digitally responsible. So now you know how to set up parental controls for iPhone and iPad, but what are you going to do when the screen time runs out? I wrote a 3-page guide about long-lasting play and how you can set that up for your kids. You can grab it down below. If you like this video, please let me know by giving it a like, subscribing, and sharing it with another mom friend. And let's stay accountable. Comment below when you've finished setting up your screen time controls. Let me know if you have any questions. See you in the next one.